Okay. Let's go. What did I pick up with the plant thing? I said it was fauna. Oh. Ionic liquids? I don't need that. Six of them. It's like 3 kilos, I guess, of it. May I help you? Place looks different on that side. Alright, I think this is our final stop here in this district, Euphorika.
Coming
down your third velocity.
Let's me forget everything else for a bit.
By the third chimera, you're floating on freaking cloud 9.
Looks like you need to relax.
I don't know about you, but that's where I'd rather be.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I guess you're right. Where the hell did Micah learn to mix a drink like that anyway?
Well, let's face it, some people are just gifted.
What's all this? A mission board, bounty clearance. Yeah, pretty standard. I'll talk to Micah first. I'm good.
Welcome. Please, make yourself comfortable.
Oh, thanks.
I can offer you a drink, or perhaps you're here seeking access to our members' lounge, where you can enjoy your Aurora experience in peace.
A members' lounge? Tell me more about the members' lounge.
Customers choose our lounge because they desire a more relaxed and sedate journey as they experience the joy of Aurora. We have no blaring music, no crowds, no chaos. The mood here is specifically crafted to allow a full range of mindful self-exploration.
Your face is, overexposed. Can I purchase Aurora here? No, right. Only at the Astral Lounge.
Sorry, no. Aurora sales are only permitted through the Astral Lounge. We simply provide a safe haven for you to enjoy it in peace.
Well, that's always a good thing.
If you desire access to the lounge, you can purchase admittance for a completely reasonable fee.
No?
Otherwise, you're welcome to relax, listen to our music, and perhaps enjoy a chimera.
5,000 credits for access? You said it was, reasonable. What's a chimera?
It's a specialty alcoholic beverage only served here at Euphorika. I'm sure you'll enjoy it.
Hmm. Any other perks come with access to the members' lounge?
Not only will you be able to experience one of the most exclusive Aurora lounges in Neon, you also have access to our private bar.
Oh.
The bartender down there is a personal friend of mine, and he sells some rather unique items.
Final buy access. We have to check it out, don't we?
A wise choice. Here's your access key.
Thanks.
Please let us know if anything in the lounge interferes with your comfort. If you need anything else, please, don't hesitate to ask.
The lack of 5,000 credits in my account causes me discomfort. I'm looking for Ayumi Komiko. Oh, isn't she in the trade tower?
You people should leave her alone. What do you want with her?
Huh? What? Just an old friend of hers. We go way back, you know?
No way. You're going to have to try better than that.
Okay.
You debt collectors are low-life assholes. She's broke, okay?
not
now
a...
get out of my club before I get really pissed off and have you thrown into the street.
No,
are you
really?
Kidding?
I'd like to see you try.
I just gave you 5,000 credits, and you're gonna throw me out? I'm not supposed to be telling people I'm from the Crimson Fleet, I don't think. Can I say I'm not a debt collector without saying I'm from the Crimson Fleet? Okay, fine. I'm no debt collector. I'm from the Crimson Fleet, but on the down low, okay.
The Crimson Fleet? Oh my, I'm sorry. I had no idea. I didn't mean anything by it, really. Mm. Sorry, I just... Well, I worry about her. Ayumi owes a lot of money around town. I'm trying to help her out. But, you know, I have a business to keep afloat. If you want to talk to her, you can find her in the members' lounge. You already have access, so you should know the way.
I've never been there. Locate evidence to extort her. Kill her, or what? I wanted to ask more about Komoko. Okay, never mind. What drink do you recommend?
Of course I recommend our house specialty, the Chimera. It's a unique triple-layer drink that I believe you'll find quite delightful. Mm. It consists of mild cold soju on the top.
Soju?
A thin layer of fruit liqueur in the middle, and a strong dark soju at the bottom.
What's
the initial
soju?
Mildness of Chimera slowly warms the senses, which rapidly transitions into a sudden burst of sweetness from the fruit liqueur. This sweetness braces the palate for the impact of the much stronger, robust finish. It's a drink of my own design.
Okay. Let me look at your drink menu.
We have plenty to choose from.
Wine list, whatever. You only have 10 to choose from. This is Chimera. Canned cocktail of 3 different liqueurs. It helps with damage resistance and persuasion and brings down O2 recovery. Okay.
Don't forget to ask Q to see our special menu.
Nothing beats getting zoned in the members' lounge.
Mm-hmm. Alright, let's... That guy anything? Oh, he's a disciple person.
You try anything, you're dead.
Oh yeah?
Ebbside is ours. The Strikers are a bunch of babies. Afraid of a little blood.
Oh, I sat down.
I'm watching you.
Alright, so... Talking to the warlord, I'm gonna take another one of these. As you see, I hate when they do this. Hippolyta, right? I'm trying to use the stolen one. Takes from the other.
You like art?
No. Sure, I like art.
Then you should see the tag job on the robot at Neon Tactical. It's my best work.
Neon Tactical. Do you consider yourself an artist?
Only when I have a knife in my hand. The rest of the time, I just paint.
Oh. So you're like a murderer artiste. Are you in a gang?
Are you in a gang?
Sound like a middle-aged bank teller. Yeah, I'm in a gang.
Bank teller.
The Disciples. Maybe you've heard of them.
Well, Frank Rennick wants retribution for what you did to Styx. He's stupid to ask somebody why they hang out somewhere.
That Cyclops should be thanking me.
Oh, you call him a Cyclops?
I dressed up his toy real nice, gave him a total makeover.
Okay, he got a patch?
That's all I did after what that thing did to my crew.
Right, he's got an eye patch, so you call him a Cyclops. Clever. Not really. So, why did you tag Styx?
I thought it was pretty clever. If I trashed it, it'd stink for a bit, but he'd get over it. So, I took a can of spray paint and put my tag on it. Now, every time that Cyclops opens up that eye, he's gonna see my art on his buddy.
Hmm. Did Styx really kill members of your crew?
We tried to rob his store and reload our crew. That's when his little toy unloaded on us. Lost some good disciples in that group. If anything, that freak should be paying me.
Well, you're trying to rob him, but you admit to the crime, though.
Yeah, I do. And I'll make art out of your guts if you step out of line.
My guts are already artful enough. You're gonna pay for the damages to his robot.
And what makes you think I will?
My Hippolyta that I took. Rennick's not all there in the head. Do you really want him as an enemy?
Yeah, it's hard to predict, crazy. Never know what he might do.
No, not leaving until you pay up.
Damn, you're annoying.
Thanks. Yeah, you don't want to start a war with a gun shop owner.
Now the old Cyclops got us outgunned, that's for sure.
Cyclops with apostrophe S? Just pay up and I'll leave you be.
I can't believe I'm actually considering it.
I know you'd like to help me if you could.
I hear you.
One more. You don't want to mess with me. Just pay up.
Man, if it gets you out of my face, I just might. All right. The Cyclops is one thing, but I know better than to mess with you.
Nah.
Besides, that Model A shredded my gun arm. I can't aim straight, let alone paint. Here, you give this to that freak and tell him we're even.
Warlord's credits added. Cool. Why do you hang out in here anyway?
Euphorika is home for people like us.
Yeah?
And by people like us, I mean killers, thugs, and thieves. Now, I haven't killed anyone in a while, but that just means I'm due.
Oh, good for you.
Yeah, beat it.
I'm watching you.
Just had to throw in his little
Those chimeras really pack a punch.
All right.
Micah knows how to make a drink.
We paid a lot, so we might as well avail ourselves. Besides, I want to talk to what's her name. Hi.
If you require any Aurora to enhance your experience, you let me know.
I thought you can't sell it here.
Hello there. On behalf of Euphorika, I welcome you to our members' lounge. I'll be happy to provide whatever you need from our private bar to enhance your experience.
Mm-hmm.
Can I get you anything? Some Aurora, perhaps?
I thought you couldn't sell it. I thought Micah told me Aurora can only be bought at the Astral Lounge. Okay, I guess it's on the down low kind of thing.
Yes. Well, due to the extreme exclusivity of the members' lounge, we like to keep the fact that we offer Aurora confidential.
That guy's gonna...
You can rest assured that purchasing Aurora from this establishment is not only safe, it's completely legal.
Really? I thought it wasn't. Nothing for me right now, thanks.
Of course. No purchases are required. You're more than welcome to simply relax, absorb the energy, and center yourself.
Center myself.
We also offer an assortment of beverages, so feel free to browse our selection anytime.
Mm-hmm. How'd you end up here, Q?
Begging your pardon. I find that fraternizing with the customers can lead to problems. I prefer my private life remain my own.
Oh, come on.
No offense intended.
All right, I can respect that, I guess.
Thank you. Let me know if I can help in any other way.
Let me see what you have on the menu anyway.
But of course, take your time.
So here's the Aurora. Huh. Not sure I've ever seen it packaged like this. Maybe I did and just forgot. No fresh. Powerful and addictive hallucinogen derived from Voli Alpha's local chasm bass population, legal only in the city of Neon. Immobilizer. Can you tell me about anything about Ayumi Komiko?
Miss Komiko is a dangerous person who's involved herself in illicit activities and associates with known criminals.
Oh, she's right over there, isn't
she? She's clearly using Micah for her own nefarious purposes. Nothing would make me feel more relieved than their relationship coming to an end.
Well, so you won't say anything about yourself, but you have plenty to say about other people, I see. How do you know Kumiko is involved in illicit activities?
It doesn't take a genius to deduce that there's some sort of illegal activity going on involving Miss Kumiko and Benjamin Bayou. They've met down here in the members' lounge on more than one occasion, and frankly, they don't even attempt to be discreet about their discussions. Mm. I overheard them arguing about electrical components, delivery dates, and huge amounts of credits being split between them.
How much do you know about Kumiko and Micah's relationship?
They met about a year ago, when Miss Kumiko visited Euphorika to purchase some Aurora. At first, they seemed very happy together. But recently, Miss Komiko's become more abrasive, and the two have been a bit distant from one another. Mm. Micah thinks they're in love, but I'm concerned that she's becoming a pawn in Miss Komiko's criminal activities. I can't bear to see Micah's heart be led astray. I trust one day she'll find a woman who will give her the love and respect that she deserves.
Okay, wow. Yeah, slurping a drink, if you heard that before, that's why that weird slurp noise happened. I don't see a reason to say this.
Please, let me know if you'd like any Aurora.
That's quite all right.
Okay. Hello.
Hi.
If you're hiring, I could really use the work.
What's your area of expertise? I don't know why I like to ask him this.
Engineering is my specialty. I'm trained to optimize your repair systems to keep your ship up and running.
Hmm. I don't really know.
Okay. Maybe next time then.
Love the vibe of this place.
Mm-hmm. He's humming. There's Kumiko. There's Syndicate people. Bathroom has its own locked area. Like, why? You can't get... The only way to get in the bathroom is from using the pass over there. So why don't you need also... Why do you also need a pass there? Right? But never mind that. I think I hit my mouse button.
You try anything, you're dead.
I already just tried to blow up the bathroom. You been paying attention?
I'm watching you.
Hi.
Yeah. What do you want?
$1 million. You work for Genodyne, right?
Before you continue, let me save you some time. If you're having a problem with your power or complain about your rates, you need to contact our customer service department.
No, that's...
Anything else?
That's not it, man. That's not it. I need a way into the Genodyne power facility.
You must be zoned out of your mind, because there's no way anyone sober would say something like that.
Oh, time for this right now. Kill everyone. The Crimson Fleet is asking, not me.
The Crimson Fleet, huh? This is interesting.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me, what does Delgado need with my Pastor Genodyne?
I'm after the conduction grid tech.
So, let me get this straight. You want me to sneak you into Genodyne so you can steal the only profitable piece of technology the company's come up with in decades.
Exactly.
If you expect me to take a risk like that, then it's going to cost you some major credits.
Since when do you care about taking risks?
Do you have any idea what Benjamin Bayou would do to me if he found out we were even having this conversation? If I'm going to let you into Genodyne, I need a backup plan. Namely, money to get off-world, fast. You understand what I'm saying?
Hmm. I'd have to pay you a single credit.
Yes, you do. Short of taking it off my dead body, which would never happen thanks to my Sioga buddies here. You don't pay, you don't get the pass.
No persuasion, huh? Pay what amount of credits? I have no idea how much money I'm going to be giving to her right now. I don't have that kind of money right now.
Then you better go find some, because this pass isn't going to come cheap.
Damn.
Bring back the money for the pass. Or are you continuing to waste my time?
Here, this is all you're getting.
You've got yourself a deal.
How much is it?
Here.
4,000?
Take this pass. It should get you through the storage room entry to the facility. I'm warning you, though. Once you're inside, you're trespassing in a high-security zone. That means they shoot on sight. Good luck. You're going to need it.
I'm supposed to get someone's clearance or something like that.
I thought we were done here.
Absolute power. What exactly do you do for Jennerdyne?
What is this? A job interview?
Yeah, I'm hiring.
I'm the COO of the company. Second to the top. Right under our esteemed CEO, Mr. Harada. Also known as Benjamin Bayou.
Why is it
called
that?
So when you ask me what I do for Jennerdyne, the answer is nothing. The Bayous run the show, and I tread water. The salary helps, of course, but at the end of the day, I'm just a joke. Sitting in an office to make things look legitimate.
Hmm. Why does Benjamin Bayou have to hide the fact that he's a CEO? And why is he called Mr. Harada, whatever?
Keeps him off the Freestar Collective's radar. They might actually step in if they discover that the same person controlling the city's regulations and bylaws benefits financially from them. Hmm. If you haven't figured it out by now, Benjamin has a stranglehold on the city. You can't take a piss without him charging you after flush. Try and get in his way,
imagine.
And then he uses neon security to beat you senseless, or the Sioga Syndicate to make you disappear.
Wow. Is there something personal going on between you and Benjamin Bayou?
That's none of your goddamn business.
That's a yes. I'm not paying you for that kind of information. Just you didn't ask for money.
Well, that works out for me, because it isn't for sale.
I'm guessing there's not much love for how things are progressing at Jennerdyne.
If you had to work with Brayson Bayou, you'd understand. The man is still a totally incompetent fool, and he's running our company into the ground. The worst part of it is that he's Administrator Bayou's brother, so I can't fire him. I can't reassign him. I can't even yell at him. It's like having a cut on your body and you're helplessly watching yourself bleed to death. Except in our case, we're hemorrhaging money.
Well, do I want to do this? Pay her?
That's none of your goddamn business.
Here's an amount of money that I don't know how much I'm giving you. I want the whole story.
I don't know why you're so interested in my personal life, but if you insist on throwing money at me to hear it, that's fine by me. A few years back,
that's all right.
The previous CEO of Jennerdyne went missing. As the COO, I was next in line for the job. Instead, Bayou muscled his way into the company and gave me an ultimatum. Either back up his bullshit Mr. Harada identity, or I'm gone. I had no choice. But I decided right then and there, I was going to do whatever I could to take what was rightfully mine. If that meant seducing Bayou to tip him off balance, then so be it. Luckily for me, Mike has been incredibly understanding about the whole thing.
What happened to the previous CEO?
What do you think happened?
He died?
Bayou started sticking his nose into Jennerdyne's business, all but outright demanding a cut of the profits. In response, the CEO made a huge mistake by threatening to take his grievances to the FC. His shuttle never arrived. Need I say more?
Oh, well. It's nice to have someone like that by your side.
Micah is the only person in this godforsaken city that's kept me from going completely under. She doesn't want money, doesn't use me for influence or as a stepping stone to get ahead. She loves me for being me, and I love her for being the same. And when this stupid bullshit is over, and Bayou is 10 fathoms deep under Neon, we'll be there for each other. Forever.
Hmm. Well, good luck with that.
I just know this is gonna come back to bite me on the ass. I just know it.
Well, stay seated. And your ass won't be bitten. What is this? Hookah canister. Interesting. Alright. Let's go. See if there's anything else to say.
Come in and let your cares melt away for a while.
Do you mind telling me how Q ended up working at Euphorika? Yeah, you wouldn't tell us.
Q's journey was very personal. He went through a lot of pain before he found himself at my door. It wouldn't be proper for me to tell his story, but mention his Geguli and you might make him feel more comfortable.
Geguli? The hell is Geguli?
Enjoy your stay.
We run back to him now and talk about Geguli. Hey. That is. Hey, hey. Hi.
If you wish to relax with some Aurora, I have plenty available.
You sure I can't convince you to tell me your story, Q?
Perhaps I wasn't clear the first time you asked, so allow me to clarify.
He punches me.
I don't feel comfortable discussing my personal life with our customers. It leads to unfortunate problems.
What's that behind him? Micah said I should mention your gay ghouly.
Micah's talking about a toy frog she gave me right after pulling me off the streets. Silly little thing was all I had to help me focus on sobriety. When you're born in Neon, you're either destined for the top or the bottom of the food chain. There's no middle.
Mm.
My family started out barely making ends meet. After my parents lost their lives, I ended up as a street rat. That's when the gangs preyed on me. I fell in with the disciples, and they helped me keep one foot out of the grave. Barely.
Wow. Do you know what happened to your parents?
My mother was killed in an accident at the Xenofresh plant. Some type of malfunction with the machinery caused her death.
Mm.
Her absence sent my father into a deep depression. He became despondent and listless. We barely spoke for over a year. Every night, I'd find him sitting on the edge of the upper platform, staring out into Volai's ocean. I'd bring him food and leave it beside him. One morning, I returned to his usual spot, and he was gone. His food was still there. And at that moment, I somehow knew I'd never see him again. That's why I eventually turned to the gangs. I had no one, no sense of belonging. I hope you understand.
Oh, completely. Why are we manipulating all these people? Like, we manipulate Micah into telling him about... Why do we want to know his story so badly? Well... This city can be a horribly unforgiving place.
Sounds like we both lived it.
Mm-hmm.
You see, all that violence, all the drugs and death, it takes its toll. I don't mean physically, I mean mentally. I was in a bad place. Mm-hmm. I don't know what Micah saw in me, but she pulled me out of the gang. She actually paid them cash to buy me out, if you can believe that.
What?
After she helped me sober up, I asked her why she bothered. She told me I reminded her of someone she lost. She never explained it beyond that. I've been here ever since.
Okay. That's just stupid to ask him that because I'm a street rat.
Peace, solace, and serenity be with you.
Yeah, something behind him that I missed. There's a... Ayumi's offer.
Can't you see I'm busy, Estelle? What do you want?
I've decided to accept your offer.
Let's make sure this is absolutely clear. I don't want any screw-ups. I'll provide the shipment IDs, the equipment description, and schematics, and in return,
In return, I disabled the freighter, transfer the goods, and then transport it the rest of the way for final sale.
You got it. Too bad your friends back at the key don't know you're cutting them out of the deal. I wonder what they'd say if they found out.
Probably the same thing your boss in the big shiny tower would say if he knew you were funneling electrical components, right?
Well, we don't have to worry about that because neither of them will ever find out, right?
Right.
That's right, Toots. Let's just enjoy the credits and keep our big mouths shut, hmm? After all, it's just good business.
Hmm. Genardyne Corporate, Ayumi's offer evidence. Confidential audio content. I wonder if he recorded this.
Okay, that's it. Time to sell some of your junk.
I'll shoot you. I crashed into her and knocked over a bucket. So, that's interesting. I guess he recorded it and then just left it back there. Alright.
What can I get for you?
Nothing. Nothing, honey.
Nothing beats getting zoned in the metal sound.
Okay. So I think I've seen all this place.
Yeah, yeah. I know this place stinks, but it's a living.
Yeah, I've been in here. And it looks like there's shops here, but you can't really go in them. You can't buy anything. Oh, wait. I can't just be picking locks, right? Have people gathered?
I heard they had a breakthrough at the lab recently. All kinds of new possibilities, they say.
Berg-ug. Can I get down there without dying? Locked warehouse. Yeah, I haven't been over here. I'm finding locked warehouses. Stuff over here. Fragmentation mine. Shrapnel grenade. Cool. Alright. Some stuff. Why is there a protective railing here but not there? Like, you can survive this? I'm just gonna save really quick and we're back here. Wait, are they gonna search me for contraband? Yeah, she's running back this way. Took a while to find your way to me, huh? Swiftly approaching my doom. You've been caught leaving with Aurora. It's illegal to smuggle Aurora outside of Neon. Guards will now attempt to arrest you.
Don't be stupid! Stop! Now!
But I'm just going back in Neon.
You're making things harder for yourself! Neon Security! Stop immediately!
I'm coming in! I'm not leaving.
Neon Security! You're under arrest!